The art of falconry has been around for over 3,000 years. I'm at Wingspan in Rotorua to find out what it's all about.
Take your time, make peace with the day. Light on the ground, think of me. And never mind.
Here at Wingspan, we are using falconry techniques as a method of training our birds to essentially prepare them for life in the wild so that they're going to be able to make it. The falconry, of course, goes back something like 3,000 years. And originally it was a way in which you could train your bird, whether it be a hawk, a falcon, or an eagle, to be able to catch food that you could provide for your family on the table. So it was a survival method for people.
So can anyone become a falconer?
In New Zealand, no, because they're all protected species. You need permits from the Department of Conservation and...
I'm too knows. Boring now.
No food, no bird.
First rule, of course, is to get your bird to come back when it's called. So what I'm going to do is throw a little piece of chicken in the air and she should alight from these trees at a rapid pace. She'll probably drop down quite close to the ground, typical flying for a falcon, and then she'll rear up and make quite a steep climb to try and grab it. These birds are hunters, top of the food chain, and generally they only take prey. So essentially they have to be able to fly faster than everything else before we let them go, or they're simply not going to make it. We use a lure. And the idea of the lure is basically a bit of leather, some feathers attached with a little piece of meat. And we start off training the birds by suspending it in front of us. Now once they accept the lure and they know what it's all about and there's a little bit of a reward for them, then we change the rules. And when they come down for it next time, we pull it away from them. And that will make them fly through, turn around, come back and try and hit it again. And this is what builds up fitness as well as manoeuvrability, just like they would need to do if they were chasing something themselves. And the first thing they have to learn is mid-air contact, quite important for a bird that might chase other birds. Secondly, they've got to try and grab the lure with their feet. Falcons, hawks, owls, eagles, they always strike with their feet first. That's where all the power is. But the other thing they have to learn is impact. Falcons are the fastest in the world, and peregrine falcon, they've been clocked at 240 kilometres an hour. So you can understand being hit at that speed is going to be fatal for their prey and very successful way in which they can hunt.
These birds here are the ones that we bring out. They fly well, certainly, but they're nowhere near as fast as wild birds, which have to fly for their living, basically.
So how long have you been a falconer for?
Over 25 years now. I've been working with them. The birds themselves are quite addicted to
them,
so yeah.
Falconry is still practiced here at Wingspan in Rotorua, and although the art was established as a technique for hunting, here it is used to exercise and rehabilitate these beautiful birds.